So Bob Gates, who kept singing the praises of the power of the Soviet Union and the threat of the Soviet Union and the ominous nature of the Soviet Union, he was sitting essentially in the halls of Congress trying to defend these views while the Soviet Union was coming apart like a house of cards, because as several of us were saying at the CIA at the time, including myself, the CIA was indeed a house of cards. That's why it collapsed like a house of cards.
All right, now we only got 3 minutes to talk about the entire war on terrorism. Sound good? What's your assessment of al-Qaeda? You know, I just read this great article by Peter Bergen and another guy in The Independent, and he's, of course, interviewed Osama bin Laden and is, you know, truly an expert. And this article is saying, you know, these guys have a lot of blowback to suffer from themselves. They've killed a lot of Muslim civilians over the past few years, and a lot of people are sick and tired of it, including people who used to support the al-Qaeda movement. And, you know, it seems to me like maybe the 9/11 attacks, as John Mueller put it in his book Overblown, rather than being the cutting edge, the vanguard of this giant Islamo-fascist caliphate, this was really a last gasp, a Hail Mary attempt on the part of Osama bin Laden to bring America into the Middle East in order to, well, the Ladin Doctrine, right, the boiling cauldron, in order to stir everything up. And I just wonder what you think, now I've taken up a minute of your answer time with my question, I wonder what you think can be done about the war on terrorism in a minimalist fashion so that we don't have to continue down this road.
Well, I think two things are important. One, I do believe that 9/11 was the beginning of the end for bin Laden. And once we get this into some kind of a historical perspective, we'll see that terrorism is not an existential threat to the United States. We can deal with terrorism. And then bin Laden actually made a huge mistake when he attacked the United States on 9/11, because he was essentially routed at the time. And the national organization or the international capabilities of al-Qaeda are not what they used to be. They cannot pull off the complicated international operations such as 9/11. But the lesson we haven't learned, and this helps al-Qaeda and bin Laden immensely, is that you can't fight terrorism with military policy. I think the British learned in dealing with the IRA that it takes police work, it takes intelligence work, it takes international liaison and effective cooperation by both intelligence officers and police officers to deal with terrorism. And the big mistake we made was abandoning the struggle against Afghanistan and al-Qaeda in 2001 to go into war against Iraq. And that self-fulfilling prophecy that Bush made when he talked about Iraq as the center of against terrorism. Well, Iraq wasn't involved in terrorism. Saddam Hussein didn't permit terrorists. He didn't permit al-Qaeda in his country before we entered the country. So we have created the opportunity for the real threat from al-Qaeda, which is not al-Qaeda itself or bin Laden. It's these copycat al-Qaeda groups that you have in Algeria and Morocco and Indonesia and the Philippines. But even there, we've had some serious successes with regard to al-Qaeda, successes in Indonesia, successes in the Philippines, successes in Iraq, for that matter. And even in Afghanistan, you have al-Qaeda hold up in the disputed territories of Pakistan, where they're going to be very difficult to get at. But again, it's going to take cooperation and international liaison and great patience. You're not going to do it with 150,000 troops in a country like Iraq, which has totally destabilized the entire Middle East. And now we can look around and see $4 a gallon oil, and maybe it'll soon be $6 a gallon oil. You can thank George Bush and Dick Cheney for that.
All right, everybody. That's a taste of what you get in this book. It's called Failure of Intelligence, The Decline and Fall of the CIA by Melvin A. Goodman. He was a senior analyst in Soviet affairs at the CIA for 2 decades. He later served as a Soviet analyst at the State Department, is currently a professor of international studies at the National War College and a senior fellow at the Center for International Policy. And his other books are Gorbachev's Retreat, The End of Superpower Rivalry in the Third World, and The Wars of Eduard, I can't say his name, and the End of the Cold War. All right. Thanks very much for your time today, Mel.
Thank you, Scott. Good to be with you, and thanks for taking the book so seriously.
Oh, yeah, it was great, and I'll get you that soundbite as soon as I can.
Thank you. Appreciate that.